Good afternoon. Well, yeah, it's about 2:30, but look at these shadows. They're huge. Anyway, so lots of people are asking how to drive these things, what the buttons do, and it's kind of tiring to type it out all the time, so I thought I'd make a video. This is a 1985 T3500, and it might be a little bit different to yours, but that's okay. Difference is part of the fun. We have the stone guard, the light bar, the two sets of headlights. They are factory, a sealed beam. Mine are a H4 low and high and a H1, so on and so forth. The let's go in here, I guess we'll jump in. So starting from here, we have a few switch blanks. This one's got a driving light switch in it. We've got the exhaust brake switch, and that controls a valve down under here somewhere. You can see it there it is. So when you are off the accelerator switch there, and the clutch and the switch is up in there, pardon the squeaks, the exhaust brake works. It activates a flap in the exhaust, and it basically puts a whole bunch of back pressure into the engine and slows you down. So that's what that does. Door open and close. If you have a factory sliding door in your bus or motorhome or whatever, then it will work like this. So that's pretty fun. This has been complied as a motorhome, this one, and it is allowed to be a motorhome because it has, it's a certain year model. After a certain year model, you need to have a motorhome door or a caravan door. This one does not. Now, that is the brake and clutch fluid filler in there. Obviously, you've got the key lock for steering lock, accessory on and start. Pretty simple stuff. You have here the headlights. That's Parker's. That's on. That's high beam. Looks like that on high beam. And the other side is the same as well. You have indicators. Oh, it helps if the thing's on. Indicators. And hazards on the top. Next, if we climb in, this is where some of the fun stuff starts. So here is the wiper switch. You can see that there, it's pull for washers. Push down for wipe once. Intermittent, on one and on high. Over here you have the two transmission gear sticks, so you've got the 5-speed there, looks like that, and you have the high and low selector for the 2-speed Joey box, looks like that. You've got here the heater controls for recirc and fresh. Fan speed, heater, which mine doesn't work, but that's all right, and the air direction in there. Here you have the rear wiper, push to activate. And push again to wash. Mine doesn't wash, but that's all right. Clock, hitting reset, resets it to 12. Hour changes the hour by one, and minute changes the minutes by one. Ashtray here, pretty simple. To take it out, you do that, and then it just all just comes out like that. We put our our fuel cap key in there, and it works quite well. Here you have a couple of vents for the aircon. Well, I say aircon, it's for the fan. Now down here, we've got the handbrake, which is deactivated quite simply, and that's like this. Pull and turn, just like it says, nice and easy. Now this one, this is the auxiliary engine heater is what it's called. Now, when that is on, what it does is it activates the exhaust brake, and the exhaust brake being this one here. Now, when the engine is running and the button is in and you are in neutral, like that, the exhaust brake will be active and it will help to create the back pressure we spoke about earlier. And when there is more pressure, there is more heat. The engine has to work harder to keep itself running and therefore will warm up a little faster. It's perfect for winter conditions, snowy Japan, that sort of stuff. And here I can give you a little example of it. So that's running in neutral and that's on, if you can hear that. And that's just toggling it on and off like so. If I were to hit the clutch pedal, it would also take it off. Here, I'll show you that. So that again is nice and simple, that one. Now, what else have we got here? We have the idle up. Start it up again. We have the idle up, and this is used to run PTOs, to run tipper bodies, concrete trucks, that sort of stuff, when you have equipment that's powered off the engine and not off like a generator or batteries or things like that. So you would use this in the truck. See how it's not revving down? So then we put it back to idle. Give it a rev. Alright, make sure it's happy. We have this cigarette socket in there. Everyone's seen one of those before. Here we have the rear heater fan control. I'll show you that in a moment. That is a vacuum alarm. So when you run out of vacuum to run the brakes here, and I'll just try and drain it. When you run out of vacuum to try and run the brakes, you will get an alarm and the light coming on like that. But it should go away when the engine is running like this. So it should go away like that. Pretty simple stuff. We've got a UHF that's mounted in the dash, which is what this one is. Nice and easy RJ45. The previous owner mounted a set of cigarette sockets here as well, which is also a USB, which is nice. Here we have the step light, which you can sort of see over there. I'll point that out in a sec. You've got the room lights as well, 1 and 2, and they look like this. 1 is the front one, 2 is the 2 at the back. We have a fan. Not everyone has that, obviously, because it's aftermarket. And that's kind of how that all works. It's really pretty simple stuff. Oh, and the last thing, the door control. So, because ours is older, it's a 85, we are allowed to have... Whoops, I'll just put that over there. We are allowed to have the factory door because we have the motor... And the motor has the emergency exit. If it didn't have this, we wouldn't be allowed to have it. But it does. Put it on manual. And the door works. It's also nice to lock it as well. So that's kind of what all of the buttons do. It's not really a lot more to be said. And yeah, that's basically about it. So I hope that answers all of the questions, because they're all the same question, but that's okay. If we don't ask, we don't learn. And now I'll just quickly go for a drive and show you how the twin stick works with all the double shifting and that sort of stuff. You don't have to use it if you don't want to. We do if we're heavy, if we're towing. We tow 2 ton with a little Beetle on a big heavy car trailer sometimes, and got a Jimny and that sort of stuff. So, but you don't have to if you don't want to. It can be a bit daunting for most people, and that's okay. But yeah, it's pretty simple, this one. If you've got it in P for power, it's in a lower ratio. It's actually direct drive in this one. And E for economy is overdrive. And that's overdriven then into the 5-speed. You could just put it in P and leave it forever. You could put it in E and leave it forever. You could change it up when you're in 5th and then driving along and then put it into E and you've got a slightly higher 5th gear. But really, I mean, it's up to you. But I'll run through all of them. I'll drive it for a bit in just P. I'll drive it for a bit in just E, and then I'll drive it how I do with using both sticks and all of that. So yeah, see you in a sec. Hello again. So, for those uninitiated, I guess, it's all pretty simple. As I said before, I'm gonna drive around in the performance, which is what it's called, P for performance, or low range first, and then we'll swap over to high for a while, and then we'll do both, which is a little bit of twin stick and running through and that sort of thing. But you'll see. Like I said, you don't have to do it, but it does make it a nicer drive, just momentum and that sort of thing. So let's go. So this is a 70 zone and an 80 zone. So that's all we're going to be doing. Not 100, but that's okay, because you don't often do 100 in one of these. Slow down and do it again. Now this is all slowing down on the exhaust brake too. I've not actually hit the brake pedal at all on this little run here at all. Which is really quite a good thing, especially if you're going downhill, because you don't want to heat up your brakes at all. You want to try and keep them for when you need them, if you can avoid it. Obviously, don't go out of your way, but yeah, if you can use the exhaust brake by itself, you'll have a much more relaxing time. Going
down for a postie. $3,000 in a fifth, 2.5, doing 75. That's all she's got. You can't do anything more than that. Over just here, we'll let this much larger bus go past, and we'll do it again. Alright, so, now in eco, or higher range, or some would call it 0.5, so this would be 1.5. Just under 2.5. If I go to fifth, now we're down under two grand. That's a drop of about 750 revs, roughly. And it just makes it such a nice thing to drive, especially on long stretches on the highway. That extra gear, that extra ratio is just changes everything. It really does. But of course it makes the exhaust brake a little less effective when slowing down, because it's just how gear ratios work. The higher gear you're in, the less effect it's gonna have. Like your engine, the faster you go, the faster you slow. That's 80 at 2100. Ridiculous. So much nicer. Now, of course, if you're really heavy, like we are, we tear at 4 ton loaded with all the gear to go away, and then we tow 2. So we're looking at 6 ton on a little, it's a small motor from 1985, like really, there's no turbo, there's no anything like that. So this is how we would drive it if we were loaded up and heavy. And this is how you would drive a T3500 or a Ford Trader Trayback as well. And it takes a bit of practice, and we don't have any synchros in third or fourth. The previous owner ate them basically, but it's, once you get the hang of it, it's really quite rewarding, I think. So, and again, we're not heavy, but if we were, this is how we would drive. When there's no traffic coming, of course. peak hour. To splitting that last one, just go straight in. It is what it is. You're gonna waste time and lose momentum and not really win at the end of the day. You can skip gears, you can miss, you can whatever. Doesn't really matter as long as you know where you are and where you're trying to be. My favorite, absolute favorite party tricks of this whole gearbox setup here is because the split is in front of the 5-speed, you've actually got 2 reverse gears. And if you've got a long way to reverse in a straight line or something, and you're in a campsite and your house is loud, there's a straight pipe exhaust and whatever, you get people looking at you funny because you change gears but you're going backwards. It's kind of weird. Once these people decide to work out what they're doing, I'll show you. So, reverse, and listen. Fantastic. Love it. Love it. Well, I hope you enjoyed this and learned a little bit. And for all those in the Facebook groups, you can maybe have a watch before you ask all of those questions. I can't speak for anyone else, but my fingers are getting tired replying to you or giving you the correct info, and I hope this helps, I really do. And if you have any questions, of course, just comment them below, like, whatever. I'm gonna go camping in my bus. You have a good day. Cheers.